The Honourable Member for Moncton River View, Dieppe.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. J'aimerais demander quelques questions à la secrétaire parlementaire au ministre du Transport à propos de la rivière Petit-Côtière dont mon comté, Monsieur le Président. Donc, le 25 octobre, je demande au ministre du Transport une question simple. And the question was essentially, when will the river restoration project continue? As you know, Mr. Speaker, the background for that question is that the provincial government, under Premier Graham, has bravely committed to fund and to join with the federal government in its responsibility to clean up the Petit-Côtière River, the sum of the $68 million that may be required for its restoration. Now, on October 25th, when I asked that question, the answer was that the unprecedented amounts of money for infrastructure programs, to quote the minister, would be coming, and the good discussions with the government in New Brunswick continue. That was the answer. I'm here to, this evening, Mr. Speaker, to follow up and ask why it was on November 9th that the minister leaked a letter to the press and let it be known to the premier in that fashion, through the press, through the public, that the deal was off, that the, in fact, unprecedented amount of money in the infrastructure project was unprecedented. It was zero. There was no money for the restoration of the Petit-Côtière River. There was no commitment to a legal obligation under the Fisheries Act, which the Minister of Fisheries, in his visit to Moncton, reiterated that the federal government had a legal responsibility under the Fisheries Act to see to some of the restoration of the project. Now, it seems, on the one hand, the federal government participates and funds through the good work of, I might add, of the minister from West Nova, former fisheries minister, in funding the environmental assessment, paid for the scientists to find as a fact that the river needed to be restored, that there were options for its restoration, and in light of a legal action brought by Les Centenaires Petit-Côtière in poursuite devant le Corps fédéral du Canada, at the last moment, the federal minister of transport instructed his solicitors to advise that they had no opposition to the removal of the gates and the restoration of the project, which was coupled the same day, mischievously, Mr. Speaker, by the minister of transport's leaked letter to the press. No courtesy to the federal government, no courtesy to this house, Mr. Speaker, suggesting that although they have no problem with the gates being removed, they're not funding any part of it. My question, Mr. Speaker, as a follow-up is, why is it that the federal government is denying its legal obligation to restore the Petit-Côtière River, which involves replacing 280 metres of the causeway with a new bridge, removing the fish gates and conducting extensive investigations? Why are they denying that when they've funded, and I'll give you the chiffre, Mr. Speaker, $26.6 million to the St. John Harbour cleanup. I have nothing against our good neighbours in St. John. They deserve a harbour that should be clean from sewage treatment. $12 million over the next 2 years to support the cleanup of Lake Simcoe in Ontario. $11 million over 2 years to accelerate the cleanup of the Great Lakes. And $7 million for the Lake Winnipeg Basin cleanup. And I have absolutely nothing against anybody in Manitoba or Ontario. They deserve the environmental remediation that is taking place under those programs.